Hi, I'm Nathan Burke.
And I'm Joshua Hatch.
And for our senior design project, we created electric rollerblades, or the ERB.
So this is an example of the electric rollerblade that Josh is holding here. It's not quite put together all the way, but for the most part, the motor and everything runs. And just some quick things, we have our rollerblade here. We have our belt that drives our wheel that's connected to our motor. And this is our component box holding everything that powers the motor and our controllers and everything in it.
All right, so this is our component box right here. I'm gonna take you through what's all inside. For starters, we have a microcontroller that's gonna be reading in the battery voltage, sending the control speed to our motor driver, and doing the wireless communication. That's this guy right here. So I'll just start at the front. We also got this battery right here. So this is a 3S battery, 11.1 volts. That's what's giving power to our motor driver. So that's coming through right here. We got a switch, just turn it on and off. And then that's coming to this motor driver. It's called a VESC. And so what that's doing is it's taking our signal from our microcontroller and controlling the three phases on this motor. Here's the whole angle of the whole box. And yeah, that's the component box. So we have, just to demonstrate, we don't have this completely done yet. We're still waiting for the print. But the component box is gonna attach the roller blade right here. This will be connected to the roller blades. So it should have little pieces coming off that bolt into the roller blade. And then these just slide onto each other.
So for our roller blade, we designed a wheel attachment here so that the wheel would spin but still be able to attach the motor. So this gear comes off, and what we did is we custom made everything and bolted it onto the frame of the roller blade, as you can see. And it's still in some bearings, so it rolls pretty smoothly and works pretty good. Along with that, one other part of our project that we have is we have this handheld controller that would control the speed that you want to go at. So there's a little switch on the bottom that turns on an LED, and we'll kind of go onto the inside just so you can see what's going on. But we have the same microcontroller that we used for our component box. And what it's doing is it's taking a reading from the user on a potentiometer, and depending on how fast they want to go, they move this up and move it back down, and that sends a signal to our box. And it does that via Bluetooth. Right now it's not working. We've run into some complications getting it the signals to read over right, but once it connects and works, and you should be able to control it wirelessly. All right, so we're gonna do a little demonstration of how this all works. For right now, since our wireless communication isn't working, we have it hooked up to a computer, and Josh is gonna control the speed and kind of show the direction the motor's going and everything. So we're gonna plug it in, and it's gonna pop up and show this LED. This LED is kind of a battery status indicator. Right now, since we haven't flipped the switch, it's just showing red where it's not on. But once we switch that, it should turn on and turn green, and it'll stay green until the battery is running out of charge and change colors.
All right, so I'm gonna get it going. All right, and then I just need to come into debugging mode. And so what I'm gonna be doing is I'm just gonna be changing the compare value on the PWM. That's just what we're using to control the signal. For the speed of the motor. So right now it's in hex, but it's 1063. That's what's putting it at standstill. If I come in here and change it to 1894, then we can bring it back to a standstill, and then bring it to go in reverse.
So yeah, that was our project, electric rollerblades. We're hoping to have it completed within the week, just waiting on some parts to print and a little bit more debugging. So yeah, hope you enjoyed it.